Hello students, in this program we will see how what is the concept behind out parameters in C#. So by using out parameters we can return multiple values to the calling function indirectly. By using direct return statement we can only return only single value to the calling function, but by using out parameters we can indirectly return multiple values to the calling function. So we see one example for the out parameter. I am using here one variable as a is equal to 10 and b is equal to 20 as integer, and then if I am calling one add function and passing the values a and b, and if I am returning the result of add function inside this result variable, and I am printing that result console dot using here add and subtraction. I am changing the function name and variable names as add is equal to addition of ab, and then I am printing that result as write line console.write line addition is equal to my result is inside add variable, and I am calling another function as subtraction, and I am passing same values to this function and again printing the result as subtraction is equal to. So what is the error in this program for function name addition and subtraction? Because I am not defining those functions, so compiler gives me error message for this addition function and subtraction function. So I need to create or I need to define these two functions as static int. I am returning the resulted value of addition and subtraction, so I am giving return type as int, and my function name is addition here, and this addition function accepts two parameters which are integer, and inside this function I am returning the result of this addition. Simply I am giving the return statement as x plus y. So I am passing x and y to this addition function and returning the result as x plus y. Similarly, I need to define another function which gives me the result of subtraction. Okay, so I am defining those two functions. Now error, there is no error, any error inside my program. Now what is the output for this program? 10 plus 20. If a is equal to 10 and b is equal to 20, then this addition function gives me the result of a plus b, that is 30, and result will be printed as add is equal to 30 and subtraction is equal to minus 10, because 10 minus 20 is minus 10. Now here if we observe this functionality, inside this addition function I am returning only single result. I am not return a double value or multiple values inside this one custom function, like I am returning plus result or addition result and also minus result. I can't return multiple values inside a custom function. So this is not valid, means we can only return a single value which is int type or float type or whatever you want, that particular data type. You need to mention this return type here, and that data type value you need to return from this function. Okay, here is limitation, means we can only return single value from any function. But if I want to return both these result, plus result also minus result, if I can return these two result inside single function, then there is no need to define this second function. If I can do this functionality, means returning a plus result as well as returning minus result from the single function, then there is no need to define this second function. But as per our existing knowledge, we can't return multiple values here from the single function. So instead of using this return statement, we may use out parameters, out parameter concept, out int add, and or we can say that m and out int n. And inside this m, I'm storing. I'm not returning any value from this function now. I'm giving return type as void, as I'm not returning any single value. But by using out parameter, I can return multiple values to the calling function. Here our calling function is main. Now I'm storing the result of x plus y inside this m, which is my out parameter here. And n is equal to x minus y. So I'm storing result of plus inside this m, which is out parameter, and storing minus result inside this n, which is again out parameter. Now my function is having four parameters and I'm only passing the two parameters, so it gives me error. And now my function does not returning me any value, so I'm removing this left side and adding these two extra parameters. Now when we use out parameter inside the function definition, we need to define out keyword in calling statement also. So I'm giving here out keyword in this way. So I'm passing a, b as a pass by value concept. By using pass by value, I'm passing the values of a and b respectively to x and y, and these two variables are now my out parameters. Now what is the concept behind this? Whatever the result stored inside this m and n through this function, that reflect inside this add and sub variable, which are local variables of this main function. So whatever the result stored inside this m and n variable, I can see those result, those m and n respectively result stored inside this add and sub variables. So this m and n values reflected inside this main function. So in this way, we indirectly return the multiple values to the calling function. So there is no need of this subtraction function, because both the operations I'm doing inside this single function. So I'm changing this function name as my function, and through this function I'm returning multiple values to my calling function, which is main function. Now after calling this my function, a result will be stored inside this add and inside this sub function. Addition result will be stored inside this add out variable, and minus result will be stored inside this sub, which is out parameter. Now if I'm running the program, see what is the output. If I'm running the program, then we will see what is the output. My program is compiling here. This is my output. Addition is equal to 30 and subtraction is equal to minus 10. So by debugging our program, we see line by line how our program works, how our program executes. So I'm putting breakpoint here. I'm putting breakpoint here and see the locals window by debugging our program. Now inside my locals window, a, b, add and sub, four variables, and this is the the command line argument variable, and all the variables are initialized to 0. By moving towards next line, we initialize the values as a is equal to 10, b is equal to 20. See locals window, the values are changed here. Then I'm calling this function, my function. Now I am in function, my function. So the scope will be changed. Now the scope of x, y and m n variable are started here, and there is no scope of a, b and sub variable. These are local variables inside main, so we can access those variables inside main only. Now we are inside this my function scope, so inside my function we can access only x, y, m and n variables and not a, b and sub variables. So my locals window is displaying these values. M is 30 and n is minus 10. This m value stored inside this add variable, and this n value minus 10 stored inside this sub variable as well. So after moving forward, my definition will be my definition has been terminated here, and I'm again inside main function. So again x, y, m, n variable scope is terminated here, and scope of a, b, add and sub is again started here. And inside memory, if we see, add is initialized as 30 and sub is initialized as minus 10, or add stored value as 30 and sub stored value as minus 10. In this way, by using out parameter, we can return multiple values to the calling function indirectly. We are not using the return statement directly, so we say the statement as indirectly. We are returning indirectly multiple values to the calling function. So in this way, we print the values of add and sub. So this is the this is our output. Now if I want to again the result of multiplication and division, then you can add more variables inside this. I'm stopping the debugging here and removing this breakpoint. Now I'm changing the values as 20 and 10, so that my division and multiplication gives me this correct result. MUL and out division, and inside this I'm adding these two extra variables, suppose p and out int q. Inside this p, I want to store multiplication of x into y, and q stores x divided by y. So here I am passing multiple, or I am returning multiple, four parameters or four values to the calling function. Means we are passing only two values, okay? We are passing a and b values, which are 20 and 10 respectively, by using the concept as pass by value. Means we are passing the one copy of a and one copy of b, and stored inside x and y respectively, and all these values are empty. All these variables values are empty when we pass variables to these my function. But when we return to the calling function, means after after termination of this block, we returning the values of m and p q respectively inside add, sub, multiplication and division variables. मीन्स जाताना आपल्याकडं रिकामे व्हॅल्यूज आहेत ऍड, सबस्ट्रॅक्शन, मल्टिप्लिकेशन अँड डिव्हिजन व्हेरिएबलमध्ये, जे आउट पॅरामीटर्स आहेत, पण येताना त्याच्यामध्ये व्हॅल्यूज भरून येणार आहेत. इन दिस वे, दिस इज द कन्सेप्ट ऑफ आउट पॅरामीटर्स. ओके, अँड व्हेन वी यूज आउट पॅरामीटर कन्सेप्ट, देर इज नो नीड टू इनिशियलाइज दीज आउट पॅरामीटर व्हेरिएबल्स. ओके, if we use reference variable instead of out parameter, if we use the reference concept, then we need to initialize these variables first. But inside out parameter concept, there is no need to initialize